What is in the heaven? For a thousand millennia, man could not hope to know.
Introduction to Astronomy is about showing students the intellectual rewards of pure curiosity. There's almost nothing practical in that comes out of astronomy. When you take a science course, you might hope, like, oh, maybe at the end of this course I can hypnotize my friends or try to cure cancer or something like that. And when you take astronomy, what you develop is a sense of our own significance on the largest tableau that there is in all of nature, which is the tableau of the universe.
So the right thing to do if you want to get your spacecraft into orbit with less fuel is you throw it in the direction that's been out of low Earth orbit since 1972. So even when you saw those geostationary satellites, the ring of green satellites that was going around at once.
What I love about teaching here in the Ho-Tung Visualization Lab is that we can just go to places in the universe. So yesterday I was teaching about Mars, for example. And we've sent spacecraft that have sat on Mars, and though we've never sent a human being there, we have the feeling here in the Vis Lab that we are really surrounded by the Martian landscape. And sometimes I know just what we're going to get out of being immersed in the places or in the geometry of what we're studying. And sometimes I have no idea. And you just feel, you experience the universe in a different way when you have the sense that you're in it, as opposed to looking at it from the outside. There's no way that I could do any of the things that we do in here if it wasn't for having such a whiz behind the desk.
Jonathan's mind goes about a million miles a minute. Mine goes about 100,000 miles a minute. So it's a little tough keeping track sometimes, but we make it work. You know, I've been doing this is now my 14th year coming up, and I feel like it's my first year. And it's, because I had the same rapport with Tony Avini when I first got here. We built a course together called Astronomy and Culture. We ran that for about 10 years. And, you know, as you do something for this long, sometimes you get a little, I wouldn't say complacent, but you get comfortable. This actually made me uncomfortable because I had to come up with some new methods and new programming, which usually creates new opportunities.
I know you have regular imagery of Mercury. Do you also have
a messenger?
Oh, it's messenger.
Joe and I sit down together on a weekly basis, and we try to figure out what kinds of visualizations we could use to support the learning goals for the course for that week. So if a week is talking about like how ancient astronomers began to understand the scale of the cosmos, we'll sit down and we'll talk about the kinds of observations that Hipparchus would have made in the second century BCE. And we'll be able to then look at the very solar eclipse, for example, of the year 189 BCE, when Hipparchus may have been active. And we'll be able to see the very observations that those ancient astronomers were making. We'll see them played out here on the dome above our head.
Because Jonathan Levine, the way he teaches Astro 101 is not just observation, right? Oh yeah, look, here's what the model looked like. It's more of how do they calculate it. And it was very detailed calculation. So he wanted things extremely accurate. And that's always a challenge for people who do visualizations, because most of the time we fake it to make it look good. I had to be accurate this time, and that was extremely difficult.
I know there are people out there who try to justify astronomy because of its practical benefits, like Tang. I don't really care about Tang. I think astronomy is great because it rewards just being curious and just asking questions. Some of the most profound questions we can ask now come from astronomy. There are so many ways to imagine the Earth being very different than it is now that come from having looked at other planets and other worlds. Like the moon, for example, at the same distance that the Earth is from the sun, yet a completely uninhabitable world. Venus, just a little bit closer, and yet it's several hundred degrees warmer on the surface. Mars, just a little bit further away, and appears to have lost a planet full of water. We're very lucky to be living here on our Earth. Our Earth is unique and precious. One of the legacies of astronomy I hope that my students will take from this course is recognizing that Earth doesn't have to always be the way that it appears to us to be right now, that it's worth protecting, that it's worth preserving.